All right, welcome back, everyone. Growing in Arizona, it is spring, which means it's time to get out in your garden. Don't be afraid to try something new. Renee introduces us to an East Valley gardener whose garden is full of rare tropical fruit. Sounds delicious.
Yeah, hey guys, so we are out in Gilbert this morning. Of course, we are taking a look at some of the rarest things you think you'd be able to grow here in Arizona, but we're meeting the guy that says it's possible, and he does it. Good morning, Daryl.
Good morning, how are you?
Oh, great. And we're talking about all sorts of different kinds of rare fruit that you can actually grow here in Arizona.
That is correct.
Well, thank you for inviting us into your yard. There's some of the fruit that's right over your shoulder. Can you tell us a little bit about your garden?
Sure. We have about 22 different varieties of bananas that are growing here. We have probably about 13 different guavas, and we've got several different mangoes, and we have star fruit that's right over here to the side of me. We've got passion fruit over behind you.
Let's take a little bit of a walk here so we can see. Right here you've got the star fruit, and then you go a little bit further in your garden, and we're looking at
passion fruit and bananas over here. The passion fruit's right along the wall. It grows really great on a trellis.
Okay, what makes it so that you can actually grow this stuff here in Arizona?
Well, a lot of it is placement in your yard with the microclimate and taking advantage of your walls and of course the shade that's available.
Okay. Now, I know back in 2017, you were thinking, maybe you can grow this kind of stuff here, maybe not, and you found a group that shows you how to get it done.
That is correct. I found the Arizona Rare Fruit Growers group, and they taught me all sorts of things about what you can grow in Arizona.
Wow. And so it's not just bananas, but it's all of these tropical fruits, and you've got them just about everywhere.
Yes, I do. I kind of went a little crazy.
Yeah, let's look at over here on my left. It looks like you've got, this is what it comes out as, and it's surprising to see that here.
Yes, it is. I was shocked when I found out that you could grow bananas here, but this is a really pretty hand of bananas. This one is actually called an FHIA-18 banana. It's one that's more disease resistant and disease tolerant.
Wow, it sounds like a pretty technical banana there with that kind of a name.
Yeah, it does. I don't think they've come up with a regular name for it yet.
Well, and there's all sorts of different ones. We're talking the Blue Java ice cream banana, the Cuban red. What's a Cuban red?
So the Cuban red is one that it'll come out as a red banana rather than a yellow banana.
Ah, that makes sense. Now we're looking at this spread right here this morning, and these are all things that you've grown right here in your yard.
That is correct.
Wow, walk us through a little bit of what we're looking at.
Okay, so the citrus plate, we have the big Oro Blanco grapefruit, which is the best grapefruit you'll ever eat. And then the red is the Sanguinelli blood orange. Then the orange is a Caracara orange, or the pink colored. Mm-hmm. And then we've got tangelos and tangerines of all sorts of different varieties. Of course, a regular lemon, a key lime. Mm-hmm. And then mandarin quat, that's the long, skinny one that looks kind of like a teardrop. And then kumquats, and then on the side there is a Meyer lemon.
Wow, and then we've got our tropical fruit plate here too, but I'm really fascinated with these bananas that you've got because they're supposed to taste like ice cream.
That is correct. They are very creamy, like ice cream. So a lot of people call them the ice cream banana.
Wow, okay, I'm gonna give that a shot here. Daryl, handing you my microphone, and I'm gonna try and open this banana the way the banana kings do it, from the bottom instead. And Daryl makes ice cream too, so tell me about your ice cream.
Well, we make all sorts of ice cream with everything that you see here. Every fruit that we grow, we try and make ice cream out of it.
Wow.
So we've made guava, passion fruit, papaya, mango, all sorts of citrus ice creams, and of course, we make banana ice cream, and today we made chocolate banana chocolate chip ice cream for you.
I think we could convince the kids that this is ice cream, even.
They're good. They're really good.
They're really good, I tell you. Daryl, thank you so much. How do people get a hold of your group?
So they can go online and look up the Arizona Rare Fruit Growers, or AZRFG, and there's a Facebook page, and there's also a web page. They're part of the California Rare Fruit Growers, and they're a chapter of that group.
So much fun, Daryl. Thank you so much for entertaining us this morning and showing us your garden. Guys, it's really impressive what you're able to grow here right in Arizona. Don't be intimidated. Daryl wasn't intimidated back in 2017, and look at the spread we've got this morning. Back to you in the studio.
Gorgeous and looks delicious.